Hello everybody, welcome to Bass and Bonsai. Not a topwater edition, but this is where we catch largemouth bass and I show you how to have fun catching largemouth bass. So buckle up and hang on, it's gonna be a good one. Hello everybody, welcome to Bass and Bonsai. I got you on the chesty, but I don't have the chesty on. We're gonna get out here and just do a little playing around. If you guys remember this from the bank fishing 101, this place kind of sucks here this year, but I'm taking my favorite Ultralight combo, right? Airstream Custom, the Rainy Stream, AliExpress Kyram rod, and I'm just kind of, you could call it testing, just playing around. I figured I'd get the GoPro out and record in case I did hook into something and pull in, you know, something worth making a video on. You never know. When you're out fishing and you have a fishing channel, always be recording yourself fishing. And yes, something always fires up and makes noise when I start recording. But last week, Charles caught a nice 6-pound bass and I just ran out. The SD card had filled up. But anyway, so we're gonna record this and I'll show you real quick what I'm gonna do. It's real simple. I'm gonna jump in here and just start pulling some lures out and that, you know, this rod and reel is capable of throwing. Right out here, I just heard a couple little bitty small fish like hitting or whatever at the surface. You see there's something working right out there. So I'm basically, I think it's so calm, I'll probably start with the popper and just start throwing it out there and seeing if we can catch something. So jump on the old chest and let's go. And right when I started talking about that and throwing poppers and all this and that, I was like, you know what? I need to throw just to play around with, because you guys probably hear me talking about it, see me test casting it way more than I ever throw it. And that would be one of these little guys, right? A jelly bean. You guys hardly ever see me actually fishing with these. We haven't been to the creeks and streams yet. And that's all I really intend to use these for, or times like this. I think there's something little bitty out there working. So before, even topwater would be more fun. And you know, I have the little Sonora ones. But, oh, there's, what is that? Oh, there's little bugs or something right on the bank here. So anyway, this is a little, some of these, not all jelly beans are created equal, right? Some taste nasty. Well, these little jelly bean bass baits are the same way. Some of them suspend, some of them float. It looks like we could have rain at any time. So I'm actually going to throw that out and let it just kind of count to 1, 2, you know, 3 to 5, whatever. Just count a couple. Try to remember roughly where you were and then just start coming back. And I'm just going to throw this around in a few spots. As you can see, well, hopefully you can see, it's getting very good distance. You probably want to keep the rod tip down. The slower you can stand to go, the better, more than likely. Oh, there's a peck. They're pecking at it. Oh, do you guys see that? That is a... Oh, I got one. Oh, woo. I just had to kill it and let it sit there long. A little bitty bluegill. So you see very quickly. Is it an awesome bass bait? No, not really. Will it catch bass? Sure it will. It'll catch anything. But for real little fish, bluegill, little panfish killer, right? Look at that. That's a good looking little bluegill. Oh boy. I got my pliers if I need them. I may not need them. I'll be right back. All right, right back. Fish is fine. Mouth is just fine. Whee! Now I got slime on my hands. Should have got a pick of that. Oh well. All right, we caught a fish. Game over, right? Going home. Hang on, let me wash my hand off. Hang on. Okay, hand washed off in perfectly clean water. My hands are clean, right? Not really. So, whoa, we're going to go a little further out. Now, that fish definitely... I had to actually kill it and just let him set and get under it and then decide he wanted it. So, the popper may be what it worked with that little feather. And I'll be honest, I've thought about... There's another hit. Rigging feather treble on these little bean baits, these little jelly beans. You know what? There is something working out further out. Let's just see how far I can cast this little thing out here. And I'm going to let it, now that swirl is on a little further out. That's probably I'm guessing 50, 55 feet. I think I had a hit. I saw that line jump a little. I don't know what, is that AliExpress something? My phone keeps going off. Got one. Okay. I was just barely like, oh, there's a, we got all kinds of little fish activity going on. Yeah, so as I've talked about before, I think everybody and their brother comes down here and catches bass and keeps them, or kind of has been. It's kind of the theme down here. But it does leave an awesome opportunity for these little dudes, right? Whee! So, let me wash my hands off again. Oh, my God. That's the only bad thing about unhooking those fish. You can't just grab them by the lip. Try it. I imagine I could probably cast anywhere out here. Now there's still a chance to catch a big bass. Last week I missed one almost 2 pounds and then caught one about 2 pounds right in this area. They're still here, but they're not like they used to be. You used to be able to come down here and catch, when I first started coming down here, maybe 7-8 years ago, which has been here for a lot longer, but you used to come down here and I mean it was game on. You caught some bass. They weren't monsters, but you know, it was good bass fishing. Kind of like you see me doing right off the bat here with these little bluegills. It was like that with, you know, little bass, big. And you were almost guaranteed, not every trip, but, you know, you had a chance at a 5-pounder. And I'm saying, I think there's still probably a couple in here. But you almost had, every weekend, you had a shot at, you know, a 3 to 5 pounder. Now, I think it's few and far between anything of any side. There's definitely, if you guys see that commotion going on out there, hopefully you can make that out. It is there's a little school or something. There's something going on way out there. So like I was talking about, if you're find yourself all you've got is this big crazy heavy bass gear, you're gonna benefit by picking up some sort of ultralight BFS setup. Just in a fun factor of maybe you end up somewhere where you're just, this is kind of one of your only options, right? I think, there we go. Got him. Ooh, that's a fighter. Oh, get out of that wood. Oh, he went right around the wood. Thank you. He swam, instead of going up and into the wood like a bass would, he swam all the way out around the wood for me. That's a good looking one. So, yep, a little bitty bluegill video, right? I just happened to pick this color. I've never thrown this color in here before, you know, of this little bean. I just thought kind of that off ghost white with the orange. And what made me think of this bait, because I almost thought about trying that orange chatterbait. And I'm like, you know what? Let's just try for small stuff today. I'm going fishing with Charles tomorrow. If I ever get this thing unhooked, I should have just brought the pliers with me. But I'm going fishing with Charles in the morning. I got to get to bed fairly early tonight, so I didn't really want to mess with putting the boat. Let me hurry up and get this guy in there. Whee! Getting the boat out in this little body of water and all that kind of stuff, right? So I was like, I'll just come down and play around for a little bit. I really need to go back to the camper. I brought the computer down. Oh, I had a hit right off the bat. I think I'm going to go for topwater. It'll be more fun. You can almost turn this thing into a wake bait. Oh, right there. Did you guys see that? It was like a wake bait mode. Get out of there. That's a better one, I think. Oh, that's a bass. Oh, he spit it out. Jesus. Oh, my God. That was our only bass so far. But anyway, I really need... I got the fourth... The Top Gun Wingman Edition. The fourth one. I still got to edit that footage. I'm going to try that again. I'm just holding that rod tip up and reeling it faster where it almost starts leaving a wake. Yeah, there we go. Wake bait. Oh, did you see that? Oh, I'm going to kill it. Get it. Get it. Get it. Ah. Okay, one more cast and I'm going to rig up a popper. But anyway, like I was saying, I got the... Part 4 of the Wingman one, the final one. I'm going to make sure it all fits on that final video. It'll be a 4-part. That's a new body of water me and Charles hit for the first time, and it was kind of tricky to get figured out, and there not every color of chatterbait was working, but chatterbaits and worms were the thing. We tried it. I think Charles, oh, there, got him. Oh yeah, get up, stay hooked. Oh, the bluegill, oh, he's barely hooked. It was game on once we found a couple colored chatterbaits that worked, and then the worms. But check out those videos. Now I'm wiping my hands on these shorts. They're gonna stink. But definitely a honey hole that, and like in, I've had one part of that, you know, even honey holes, like even right here, you gotta figure out what's hitting. You might say, oh wow, you're catching a fish every cast, but you might come out here with a bigger bait and you may not get anything. Downsize to what's, you know, particular time, whether it's bass. Oh, I pulled that dude right in. These little bluegill or whatever, and find what they're hitting on. I'll be honest, I did not pull up thinking I would be doing this. I pulled up thinking that new orange chatterbait, as you'll see in that video, it's the first time I threw that color. I got from AliExpress, intended on using it for a black and blue with a gold blade. So I got that head, the chatterbait, basically because it had a gold blade. And Charles was the one, he's like, oh man, I really like that color. And I'll be honest, I'm like, I don't really like that color. It had a lot of orange on it. But to be honest, I don't think I'd ever had a chatterbait that color. And I know I've had spinnerbaits similar, and I do not like it. But see, a chatterbait, I think you're trying to imitate a crawdad. A spinnerbait, you're trying to imitate a fish. And I know everybody will say you run different stuff or whatever, which is true. But some colors translate way better for chatterbaits than they do for spinnerbaits. Now, yeah, white kind of works for any bait made, right? This bait, soft plastic, hard baits. But then on that video, you'll see, I was getting ready to talk about before I keep catching these fish, is Charles, I think he caught maybe one, maybe two fish on a hard bait. I don't think I caught one fish on anything other than a chatterbait. I did a jerk bait. There was a bite going on out, a hard bait, jerk bait, but that was it. When I was throwing square bills and anything I threw up in the bank, you probably didn't see a lot of the footage because there was just not, let me try it way out here one more time. There was just not, you know, that kind of bite going on, man. Those chatter baits in a couple colors and the worms up under the, you know, where the flooded trees got to a final point. Towards the end of the day, in that morning, it wasn't really a game on kind of deal with that bite. But as the day went on, I think they moved out away from the bank down to those trees, and then it was game on. Got another one. Have you guys been keeping count? I don't even know how many of these suckers I've caught. It is definitely these little suckersville. And if you do have a 5-pound bass in here, that's food. Those little suckers right there. 5-pound bass can devour those. And they're way out here though. So yeah, I am gonna throw, I'm gonna get to it. I'm gonna throw a popper. I'm just debating on which popper should I throw. I think I got the one, I wish I had one actually this color with that little bit of orange. I think all I have on the little poppers is I've got a ghost silver, a ghost gold, the fire tiger, which would probably be what I put on. You know what? I'm just going to be patient on this cast. I'm going to cast this one out as far as I can. Well, close. I kind of threw it down a little, but I'm just going to let it set. Now, you try to watch that line right where it's, see it just, you watch that line, and if you see it, like you'll see it jump, you can, it's like a strike indicator, that braid just sitting on top of the water right where it goes in the water. It could just all of a sudden go down more, but I'm gonna let it set. I'm gonna hold the rod tip down. I'm gonna reel it slow. I'm kind of trying to get it to go deeper. This little video, I guess, I don't know. I guess it'll be called Fishing with the Jelly Bean, Catching Bluegill. on ultralight BFS gear. But let's go to the popper. Okay, part of me just wanted to grab one of those little mini whopper ploppers, but I'll be honest, I have not had the luck with those like I have these little dudes right here. It started out gangbusters in cold water, but then it's kind of slowed off since then when I do try those. But this little dude right here, and we're going to sneak up. Always be aware when you're bank fishing. Be wary of snakes. All right, let's try this spot. Just like that, first cast. That sucker nailed it. That is a bluegill again. No, wait. Oh, that's a green sunfish. Different species. We've only caught two now. The bluegill's right and left. This green. See the difference? Big old mouth, bucket mouth like a bass. Kiss that one. Mwah! Awesome. These are my favorite. The bluegill look better. These look meaner. These are my favorite to catch because they have that mouth more like a bass. They're more prone to, I don't know, I guess hit bigger baits. Let's get right back out there. Same spot. But kind of awesome little trip already just in catching them little ones. Now, the kicker would be another bass like the one I had missed, or a bigger bass, or just a monster. There's also another type of, oh, I want to call it a shell cracker, but I'm not sure what it's called. It's kind of just a more plain looking one. I've caught one a couple years ago out of here. So I know there's like three different species of panfish for sure. I call them like a shell cracker, a bluegill, and then a green sunfish. And then there are crappie and bass. What's up, punk? What do you got there? Bottle rocket shooter?
Snorkel.
Snorkel? On a bicycle?
So I could go in the lake.
So you're gonna breathe? Oh, got him, Javi. Look at that, did you see that? You wanna try this rod and reel? No. Oh, that was a little bass. We cannot get a bass in tonight. I caught all kinds of fish, I know. Right now
where'd
I'm sucking.
Where'd that boat go?
Mm-hmm.
Sunk, you think?
I think somebody pulled it out probably. I don't see it underwater, so. You wanna try this rod and reel?
No!
You know how to cast a bait caster, right?
Yeah. I wanna try it though.
Why? Scared?
No, I just don't.
Scared of it? What if I catch a big old bass? You wanna reel it in?
No.
Big one. I'm gonna catch a big one. Big bass. Big bass, boy. Coming up. Coming up! Look out there. Oh, I see something. Something's about. Oh. Get it. Guys, a little bitty.
Why didn't you want this?
What is that, whore? I don't know. Handle's missing. It's like actually part for a long one. I don't know. There's all kinds of trash all over this place.
What look is that?
I don't know.
Didn't make it perfect.
Oh! I don't know why I jerked that hard. I'm what? You're going to show... Javier is teaching me how to fish.
I actually know how to fish though.
You better than me?
Yeah.
Who do you think taught you how to fish? Mm-hmm. You already know how to fish better than me.
I already know how to fish.
You knew how to fish before you fished with me?
Yeah.
First time you went fishing with me, you threw the pole in the water.
I went fishing before.
Snoopy pole. First time you went with me, you threw the Noah Snoopy pole right
no,
in the water. And we never got
I
it back.
I went fishing way before you with my dad.
Well?
One time.
Way before one time. Boy, what? Are you, look at this kid. He wasn't lying. He's going snorkeling. Look, this kid's like a dog. You take somebody out, fit you like stale of water. Spooking the fish. How far you think you're going
to
get?
Look at this.
You ain't going to get to the middle. You're nuts. I may abandon this and we'll just try the big top water. Or actually, that I want to try. What I came down here to do is try out the chatterbait, the one with the orange on it. Javier's definitely spooking anything that's along that bank. Yeah, not over here though. Oh, there we got a good long cast. Just missed. Oh, it's on the tree. It is on the. It's on the tree line. I don't know if you guys probably can't make it out. There's a dead piece of tree that I didn't see, and I stuck it. Oh boy, hang on. Get off there. There we go. All right. I'm going to get aggressive with it now. That little stuff hasn't gotten any attention of anything big. So now I'll just try kind of some big splashes. Nothing. Let's try right. I want to get about two. I want to get like right up against that. I'm doing that. You do not do what I. Did you see what I did right there? I yanked by what I saw. I did not feel anything. I saw that fish hit at it, and I yanked. That is a wrong thing to do. Let me try that again. Let's try it again. All right, we're gonna try that same shot again. Come on. Oh, he swirled on it. Just gonna move it. Oh, he got it. He's running me. Oh, get over here. I got one. He's a giant. He's a giant, Javi. He's a giant. That is weird. We caught bluegill on the little. Oh, ow, it about hooked me. On the little jelly. And yes, the little. Look at this kid. The little hooks hurt just as big as the. Or just as much as the big ones. What? Ow, just like that. Ow, I'm stuck. Oh my God. Hang on. I got a kid on a bicycle blocking me. I got a hook. That hook is buried in me. Why I'm not screaming. Hubby, come here. I'm trying to get this hook out of me. The things you guys go through. This is a little fishing trip. I'm just trying to catch a little bass.
Look at that.
Hang on. I got to get this dude out of the picture. Okay. He's unhooked. Look what I did, Javi. I got myself hooked. And that barb is in. You guys see that right under the fingernail? Oh, man.
Did you really just go flat tire?
Come and watch this. Oh, boy. You're going to... Good thing you guys can't see me. Nobody wants to see a grown man cry, but you'll probably hear a grown man scream like a girl. All right, where's my lucky pliers? Oh my God, I can already tell you. It's right now, I feel no pain. It's like I'm in shock. Let's go over here by the water. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I know. You guys feel me? Anybody else feel my pain? I want to get a close up for Jay. Jay likes these close. Look at that. See that barb that is on that one? That barb is, it's just barely in. But if any of you have been hooked, you know what I'm doing here. Okay, now I'm going to push pressure away from the barb. And I'm going to... Oh, that is the wrong way, dude. Oh, that hurt. Now I'm going to yank, but I make sure those other hooks aren't going to get me again. I'm just going to yank this out on the count of 1, 2, 3. Oh, geez. That doesn't look like much, but man, that hurts. Ooh. Oh my God. Okay, we're fine. We're good. Woosah. Woo. That stings. It's not really even the pain. It's the knowing you got to do it, right? So we got a little blood going on. And I'll be honest, I don't get tetanus shots, none of that. Best thing to do with it, stick it in the water. Oh yeah. Good to go. Good to go. Let's catch another one. This time I'll be more careful. I had the whole bicycle incident. And yeah, I'm kind of, I guess, accustomed to getting hooked by now. For those of you guys that think you're real tough, the first time, if you haven't had that happen to you, the first time it happens, you'll be surprised how much that hurts. You may think, well, I've gotten shots, and it's like, it's just a slight. But when it's there, and it's the barb, trust me, it ain't like a regular needle just coming back out. And when you know you're the guy that's got to pull it out, oh, man. Oh, boy. Let's go. Come on. Oh, something right out there again. Oh. I should have thrown way past it, but. Is that a rooster crowing? dude, his timing is way off. Can't stop the rooster. He's crowing at about, what is it, 7:30? Look at them. Wow, look at them. I just now looked up. Did you see how white that cloud looks? Can you guys see up there? I would swear that there's more light because it's hitting that cloud and it's like got it lit up like a freaking light bulb. That's a rooster crowing. What time is it? Let me see, just to show you guys. It is almost 8 o'clock. You hear the rooster? Top Gun Maverick Edition was last week, rooster. Go to sleep, you're drunk. All right, let's try one more. I'm gun shy. I keep pulling just short. Oh, there was one. Keep pulling just short of that. I'm about ready to abandon our little thing. I may even put an end to the video and just start playing around with that chatterbait. Or I could get out our mega bass, because I can throw it on this rod, I think, the Pop X. I mean, I'll have to yank as hard as I can if I get a hit, but I know the rod will throw it. Whoa! We got that. That sucker hit. I just knew that was a huge bass. Did you guys see that hit? I'm going to get hooked again. Watch out, I got a bad finger fish. I'm going to microwave that dude. That is a mean bluegill. Sucker is mean. Hang on. I should have... The green ear, I didn't grab solid. So, he got... He shook loose. Shook the hook right into me. Look at that dude. That's a dark colored one, but a good looking one. All right. Game on, game over. Let's catch a showstopper. I got enough footage and fish catches to... Ooh, showstopping time. Let's wrap up this video. Well, it stopped bleeding, so we're good to go. And honestly, it doesn't even... Like, I can't even... Oh, there's one! That's a bat. Maybe a catfish or a bass. Oh, yeah. Showstopper. Showstopping time. Oh, it's a bass. Get over here. Don't you shake it free. He's got me in the wood. I gotta go get him. He's got me in the wood. Get out of there. Come on. There he is. Oh, get over here. No. I need a bass. Get out of here. Oh, we got a bass in, finally. Jeez. Showstopper extraordinaire. Largemouth bass. He's gonna end up making... Oh, do not hook that hand. I got one good hand left today. I need it for tomorrow's fishing, buddy. I think, get a pic of that one so I can have something to put on the header. But look at this. Let's get a shot of it. That is a long, lanky bass. But that is awesome, boys and girls. See the power of these little ultralight BFS setups? A lot of fun, and you can catch some fish. Big time. Don't hook yourself, though. All right. Got a pic. I'm going to put an end to this video. We're going to let this dude go, and we'll talk real quick about the rod and reel in case you missed it. Come on. You know you want to jump. Oh, you want to jump. Come on. You know you're a jumper. You know you were born to jump. Get out there. Gone. All right, everybody. Hopefully you liked the video. I don't even know what I'm going to call it other than... Maybe have something to do with bank fishing, with ultralight BFS gear, catching bluegill and bass, right? And a green ear. I keep adding ear. And a green sunfish, just for good measures. And we hooked ourselves. That's always cool. I may throw that together in one little separate video. Anyway, get out, bass and bonsai, and be looking forward to... Because I'm going to put this up. I've had fun, but... And I may bring it back out, and if I catch another one on this setup, once it starts really getting dark. But right now, I'm going to jump to regular bass gear and chatterbait real quick. And I'm going to maybe walk around a little bit more of this pond. Anyway, hopefully you like this video. That's the Alpha's Airstream Custom on the Kyrum Rainy Stream. That's a Daiwa. You guys know what the Alpha's is, right? Daiwa Reel AliExpress Kyrum Rainy Stream rod that I actually do recommend. That is an awesome rod. It's a $200 rod, but it's an awesome rod. It is two-piece, but it's an awesome rod. Ultralight BFS rod, right? Kind of maybe designed more or less for trout, but as you can see, works awesome for panfish and bass. So get out, go bass and bonsai, but whatever you do, hook myself again. Make sure you have fun doing it, guys. We're going to pound it.